Well, hello there, everyone, and today I am talking about Deadly Premonition Origins on the Nintendo Switch. Okay, Deadly Premonition is a very unique game, a very odd game, a very funny game, and a very strange game. I still remember playing this back when it released on the 360 and covering it on this very channel, and while the game took me quite a while to beat and finish, when I did, it had blown my mind. And yes, I know this game gets a lot of back and forth discussion about why it's genius and why it is crap. And the interesting thing about it is I understand both sides, but I also feel like I fall square in the middle. I understand this game has a lot of issues. And that being said, the Switch version, for the most part, retains a lot of those core issues. And that is mostly down to the way it was designed, the way the game was made, and just how the game really has had performance issues across various console versions. It just feels like the way the game was. Now, it does feel, on this Switch version, I will say, does feel like the frame rate is better. But you still get cases of frame rate issues when driving. The driving controls are not great. The oddities of lacking music at times and overabundance of music at times is just oddly weird, but yet fascinatingly all right. So, if you've never played Deadly Premonition, you're in for a treat, most likely, if you can get over the visual style. Now, looking at it from a Switch perspective, you know, the biggest thing is the portability factor, and being able to take Deadly Premonition and go through it case by case, going through the town, exploring, doing the side quests, and controlling Zack slash York and his weird, crazy adventures. There are just an abundance of reasons why someone would love this game, from the quirky dialogue and voice acting to the odd and downright creepy moments of the killer chasing you and the people dying. It's just got an air of oddness. And at the time when I played the original game, a lot of people said this was like the Twin Peaks video games. I had sadly not had the fortunate ability to have played, or should I say have seen, that show. So I did not really understand that, but I kind of got some of the references. Now, having watched the entire show to include the new season, I totally get it. Absolutely. And I do agree, this is the Twin Peaks of video games in a lot of weird ways. Now again, the design-wise, there could be things that were, a little better. The driving, the visuals, some of the sound choices. But again, aside from the frame rate performance issues, everything else could kind of be part of its charm and character in a lot of ways. So if you can't get over that oddness, if you can't do that, then the Deadly Premonition might not be something for you. If you've never played Deadly Premonition, and now they've announced a surprise sequel, which is amazing, I'm sure it will continue the zaniness, but I'm hoping to see a little bit more improvement in just how it performs as a video game at its core basic fundamentals. I highly recommend, if you've not played Deadly Premonition on the Switch, to definitely give this game a try. I feel like it's a great port overall. If there was a sound issue earlier, that seems to have been fixed with the patch. And, I mean, get ready for the sequel. You can be prepared. But if you see this stuff and you kind of look like, this is, you know, you're a graphics person or whatever, you can't get into the weirdness that is absolutely 100% Deadly Premonition, then you might want to pass. Anyway, that's all the time I have for this video. And until the next one, take care, guys. My voice.